recalling your best performances, was there any difference in your mental game? And what about your worst performance?
I think my best performances usually came after, as a culmination of really good physical performance beforehand. So what mattered really wasn't how do I get psyched up the morning of the competition and how do I get really fired up that week of the competition. It's what did I do for the last 6 weeks or the last 2 months getting ready for this competition. And so what mattered to me was that preparation. If I did all the right things physically for the last, 8 weeks, then I've earned the right to walk onto that floor and to be confident down inside. If I really didn't do the job I know I should have done, that truth patrol is in your brain. It always reigns supreme when it comes to competition. If deep down inside you know you could have done something more, you could have done something better, then those doubts will creep in the competition, in that competitive environment. And you're going to have to just make do with the best you can. But if I've done everything that I can do, I could walk on the floor and say, you know what? There's nothing I really could have done in the last 2 months to get me more prepared than I am right now. So I'm going to be confident. And whatever happens is meant to be at that point. And so I kind of had that attitude. So I really, really placed importance on what I was doing for those weeks before. That's why I treated every day as if it mattered. Every day matters in the training.
Well, this kind of adds on to that. Did things you do out of the gym affect your abilities while in practice and competition?
Yeah, I mean, I had to make choices. You know, when I was a young child, of course, I had the childhood choices. Gee, do I go ride my Schwinn Stingray? Those were BMX bikes in my day in the 60s, 70s. So, do I go ride my Schwinn Stingray with my friends because it's going to be a fun Saturday, or do I go to the gym for 4 or 5 hours? And so, when I talk to young athletes, I always give them this statement. I say, don't sacrifice what you want most for what you want now. What I wanted now was to go ride that bike with my friends and have fun, or as I started surfing with my buddies, in Southern California, I'd want to go surfing with them. That's what I wanted now. What I wanted most was to be an Olympian. So I had a choice to make. Do I go to the beach with my friends, or do I go to the gym? And while going to the gym wasn't really as much fun at that time, there was the drudgery of training I had to face and doing a skill over and over again. Deep down inside, I knew I was preparing myself for something that I wanted more later in life. And so I was able to, I think at a pretty young age, I was able to really understand and grasp the bigger picture. And I think the more an athlete can do that, especially a young athlete, the more they're going to be prepared for what lays ahead down the road.
Go to sportsmentaltoughness.com to get your free video training and guided visualization MP3 on how to perform under pressure. I'm Craig Sigal, the Mental Toughness Trainer.